Today I'll explain what is the client libraries in AEM, what is the purpose of adding those client libraries, how you can create those, and some important properties of the client library, and how you can use those client library in your site. So what is the purpose of client library? Basically, client libraries are a specific kind of folders where you can keep your JavaScript and CSS, and you call those CSS and JavaScript as a single file in your site. But why we use this actually? So if you see any web development, you use JavaScript and CSS a lot. These are the essential part of your development. So how you use it? In JavaScript, you use a script tag, and for CSS, you use link tag to load or call your styling files in your pages. So suppose, take example, if you have 50 files, 50 JavaScript file and 50 CSS files, you will be using 100 lines of code to only include these files, and there will be the 100 network call to call each file, right? Each one file. To overcome this kind of problem, so AEM came up with a concept called client libraries. In client library, we concatenate all CSS files as a single file and all JavaScript file as a single JavaScript file, and then we load that single file on your site or your pages, so that there is only single network call, so that file can be loaded quickly. So let's see what is the structure and how you can create your client library. So basically, you have to create a node of type primary type called CQ colon client library folder. You can have any name. This name can be anything, but primary type always fixed. It should have a primary type this. Inside this, you create a folder called CSS. You can have any name for that folder. Primary type can be NT colon folder, and one file called css.txt. This file is fixed, name should be only this, but folder name can be anything. But we are just use this name as a CSS because this standard in all together or everywhere in AEM we use this name. For same way, we create one more folder called JS, and the same one more file js.txt. So basically, these folders are used to keep your CSS files and JavaScript file inside. What is the purpose of this text file? I'll explain. And from AEM 6.4 onwards, you should have one more folder called resources. This is a name specific. Folder name should be only your resources. So purpose of this folder is, if you have any static files like you have font files, you have images, logos, which you will be use in your CSS. So those files should always be under your resources folder. You can have those files in some particular folder, but those folders should be under this resources. So everything static resources, if you are loading through your client library, those should be under your resources. If you don't have those under resources, those will not load. Let's see a few important properties of your client library. Your client library should have two, three important properties. First, it is a category. Basically, the value you give in this property will be used to load or call your client library. Without this, your client library is of no use. Allow proxy. This property is mandatory since 6.4 or 6.3, and this is the Boolean kind of property. You should have always true inside this. So if you don't give this property, and if this does not have a value as a true, your client library will not load on your dispatcher. So this is mandatory. You will be seeing this client library in author, but this will not load on your publish or your dispatcher. Embed. Suppose you want to include some other client library in your client library. So suppose you want to merge the code of two client library. So for that, you use this embed. Suppose you have one client library. Take example, this is the one A client library, and there is another client library B. So to merge code of A to B, you use this embed property inside this property inside B client library. So I'll show you how this works actually. And next is dependency. Suppose you have in your client library, you required or your functionality depending on some other client library. So to run your client library, you need some other client library to be loaded before your client library. So those client library name you give in the dependence property. So suppose your client library is B and your functionality or your file or your functionality is depending on client library A. So you want that client library A to be loaded before your client library. So you give that client library A in your dependencies as a property. Both this dependency and this embed are multi properties. So that you can include more than one client libraries in these properties. So let me show you client library in AEM. Go to AEM Geeks. If you are not aware, we are using this code base, this project throughout our series. If you don't have this code is freely available in GitHub. You can go to GitHub and either you can download or clone. Just build your code and install it your local. Whole project, including pages and this code will be available to a local AEM environment. So see the client library, because this is only a folder. It does not have that property client library folder. So inside this, I have created three client libs. So basically this client library is used for my template. So throughout the site, this client library will be available. So if you see here, allow proxy true. As I mentioned, if I don't give it, this client library will not load on dispatcher. Categories, basically define the name of your client library. I'll use this name to load or call my client library in folder. Embed, I'm embedding some other client library. So once my client library will load, so this client library will contain the code or the files including this client library as well as from this client library. So if you see, I have this base, whatever is there in that base, I'm including those files inside my client library. So now this will load as a single client library with name client lib hyphen page, which include all these files and including the files of this client library base. So let's see the folder structure now. As I mentioned, this folder will contain all your CSS, and so this file css.txt, this is important. Let me open this file. So this is the code, basically effective code. If you see here, the first line is always start from hash base is equal to CSS. So this line, let me zoom it. This line will define from which folder you should start picking your CSS. So basically this is the root folder. You can give any name here. Right, if you see the CSS and the folder name is CSS. If you change the name of this CSS folder, you have to change this name here as well. And then your file name. So whatever the order you gave this name of these files, those files will be concatenating in that order. So this bootstrap.code will contain a top of your file, and then the file will be start concatenating in order. One more thing, inside folder, this you can have any number of CSS files, but only the files which mention in this css.txt, those will only be concatenated, and those code will only available in your final file. The same way it works for JS as well. This folder and this js.txt, the mention here, the my root folder is JS. It start looking these file under this JS. Let's see this resources folder. So in my client library, I am using font file. These fonts are being used in my CSS. So I always keep this folder or the files, whatever I have, under resources folder. This is the standard. So if I don't keep this under this resources folder, those will not load. Obviously the path, you have to, you know, as per whatever your path is, you have to mention in your CSS wherever you're using, but all the static assets should be under your resources folder. So let's see what is the dependency. Suppose I want some other client library to be loaded before my this client library. suppose my client library is depending on some other file, so which to be loaded before this. So what I'll give here, I'll mention as a dependencies, and this is multi-field. So to make it multi-field, you have to click first on multi and then add. Suppose my it depending on some text, there is some client library with name text, and which is, you know, which has some functionality which is required for my client library. So I would add, this is, as I mentioned, multi-field, so you can mention anything. Save. So any client library or name with text which will load before my client library, because my functionality is depending on that client library. So this is the purpose of this dependency. So let's see how you can load these client libraries, or you can use these in your site. So to include these client library, you have a specific syntax. There is a template inside libs. You have to use this template, and this template is responsible for loading your client library. You give your name of your client library as an input and what kind of file you want to load, either CSS or JS or all. So this is the syntax, and you will learn about this syntax, don't worry about it. Once you learn Sitely or STL, you will understand what are the tags here. So if you want to load or call all your JavaScript and CSS in a single shot, then you have to give this all client library, client lib all, and then the name of your client library, right? This is important. Suppose, but in modern development, we don't load your client library and CSS and JavaScript at one place. We always load your CSS first at top of the page and JavaScript at bottom. So to call your CSS, only CSS, use this syntax. You mention here only CSS, not JavaScript here. And then at bottom of the page, you can include this so that at bottom, your JavaScript will be loaded, rather than loading all together, both file together. So let's see in code how we are including it. I'm including these client library in my page component so that it these should be available throughout my site. What is the page component? I'll let you know in some next videos. So go to this structure and go to the page. Basically, this component is used to maintain resources throughout your website. So come here, but don't worry about this folder or file structure. Basically, I'll explain everything, how you can create your component and template. So now you see here, I'm including in only CSS here. So that means at starting of your head, it will add only CSS, and at the bottom of your page, it will include JavaScript file. So I created a page. So let's see, you reload page, open console. So if you see, there is a single file, clientlib-page.js. So this file, this is a single file of JS, and if you see CSS, there is a single file, this as well. So this file, CSS file, will contain the concatenation of file, means which were mentioned in CSS.txt. So all file code is there in a single file. So there is one more thing, you can minify these files as well. To minify this file, I'll explain how you can minify and all in detail in a separate video, but let me show you how you can minify right now. Go to your config manager and search for library manager. Open library manager. You have option of minify. There's lot of things comes like how, what is the preprocessor and how you can use it. So that we can discuss later. For now, just minify. What minify does actually, it will reduce the size of your file. It remove all the white spaces from your file and you will have a less size file so that it travel on network quicker. So let's come here, let's reload this page. So if you see, there is a file called min.css. Using both files, right? This is cached actually, this is not being called, this is cached. So actual file is this, which is being loaded right now. If you see, and this is same for your JavaScripts, there's a min files are used, right? So if you see, if you open this file, new tab, and open the old cached file actually. So if you see, there's a lot of spaces in this, and but in minify file, you see the code, you don't see any white space here. So the in this way you can minify your client library file as well. We can discuss in detail about minification. There's a number of ways you can do it, either for individual library and as well for the whole AEM instance, but that we can discuss separately. So I hope this video will clear all your concept about client library. If you have any question, please do comment. Thank you very much. Please subscribe and like. Thank you.